επιβάτες της πτήσης Α320 της Aegean Airlines Καλαμάτα Αθήνα με τελικό προορισμό το Λονδίνο παρακαλούνται να προσέλθουν στον έλεγχο ασφάλειας και διαβατηρίων.
So you got everything?
Mm-hmm.
You can play video games the whole flight, or you think you might actually crack a book?
Probably read some.
If I write you an email, don't be scared to write me back, okay? I won't kill you to let your old man know what you're thinking about, what's going on, you know?
Yeah.
If we want, we could try Skyping once a week or something.
All right.
You got the drawings for your science deal?
Yeah, I think so.
All right, well, they turned out great, by the way, like really great.
Thanks.
What do I, is the computer charged?
Yeah.
What do you think's the first thing you're gonna do when you get home?
I don't know.
Hmm? Really cherish this communication we have. You know, it's just, your answers are so...
What?
Just keep practicing the piano, okay? You're really good, and they spend so much time at that school of yours. Just remember that music is actually something you'll use in your life. Right, and don't forget to, you want those sesame things, right? They're really good.
Yeah.
Okay. Yasu. Here you go. Thank you. Okay. I'll probably make it over there in October, you know? Try to see you in that first recital and then hopefully catch a soccer game while I'm there. If that is though.
I might not even play soccer this year.
Oh, that'd be a big mistake, trust me.
I'm not that good.
Oh, no, you're pretty good. You are.
I mean, I missed summer training camp, so the chances of me starting are minuscule.
Yeah, well, just tell the coach the situation. You know, your dad lives in Europe. You really wanted to be there. You know, blah, blah, blah. Blame me. My parents stink, but I'm really serious.
But I'm not serious, Dad. I don't care that much.
Well, you don't have to decide right now. You know, just think about it. All I'm saying is that team sports are important. Here we are. I love this airport, don't you?
It's awesome.
I know, it's cool, right? You excited about seeing your mom?
Yeah, and all my friends.
Yeah, right. What about your boarding pass, passport? Okay. You feel confident about making the connection?
Yeah, I've done this before.
Yeah, but not with a tricky connection like this. Just remember that, you know, when you land, you stay in your seat. Somebody from the airline's gonna come get you and take you to the gate, right?
It's not a problem.
Okay, all right. Oh, boy. Well, looks like maybe we should just do this thing, huh? Hmm? Okay, come here. Oh, God. I'm gonna do my best to make that recital, okay?
You know, I wouldn't bother.
What makes you say that?
Look, I'm not being mean, but it'd be easier if you didn't come to recital.
How come?
It'd just be better if you visited on a nothing weekend.
I want to see you play.
Look, it's because Mom hates you so much. She'd be really stressed if you were there, and then be tense for me.
You know, thank you.
We wouldn't have any time to hang out anyway.
Don't worry about that. We'll figure that out. Just don't want you to worry about it, you know? I mean, you know how much I miss you, right? Why do you think she still hates me so much?
I don't know. She hates Daniel more than she hates you. Hey, don't worry about it. I'll figure something out. We should just do this.
Yeah. But I mean, is there anything I can do to help?
I don't know.
But you know that I love you, right?
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, I know. Okay. This has been the best summer of my life.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, me too. See, I told you. I told you this whole Greece thing was gonna be great.
And it was.
Okay. All right. I love you, pal.
Love you too, Dad.
Okay. Okay, shake my hand.
Bye.
Thank you.
send more.
Is it trouble?
I don't want to let this meal go by without just saying thank you to everyone, and especially you, Patrick. We had no idea what we were getting into these last 6 weeks. A letter arrives from the university inviting us to the southern Peloponnese of Greece, to the guest house of a great writer. Sure, why not? And then at the airport earlier today, Hank turns to me and he says that this has been the greatest summer of his life.
Well, right?
And I have to say the same. So thank you, Patrick, and not just for what you've done for me and my family, but for all the ways you're giving back, all right? Yeah. So to Patrick.
Thank you. You know, when I first saw you at the airport, I thought, no way a man dressed like that could be a man of letters. But now I think I've learnt your secret.
Yeah.
We've had many great writers here over the past decade, but never one who had a partner more interesting than themselves.
Oh.
Tell you.
And Celine, it's been so great to have you and your daughter's wonderful vitality around here. And I'm so happy that you were able to meet my dear friend Natalia, whose husband Elias was like a brother to me.
I'm so sorry about the curtain.
I shouldn't have gotten those cherries. It was my fault.
And Ramba, thanks for including Anna and me this summer. Because, you know, he usually puts me to work. But when I bring Anna, he let me sit at the table of the grown-ups.
Yeah. Welcome to the grown-ups table. And eventually he catches his face in the window's reflection. And he realizes he's no longer a 9-year-old boy, right? He's suddenly old. He's got a beard. His eyes are watery.
Oh, this one seems sad. At first, I thought you were going to tell me the story about the guy that has an imaginary friend.
Which one?
And when he's in his 50s, the imaginary friend shows up again,
right? With the hummingbird.
Yes.
Yeah. Are you like that one?
That's funny. Remember that letter that you let me read that you wrote when you were 20 to yourself at 40?
Yeah, I remember the first sentence. Dear 40-year-old Jesse, I hope you're not divorced.
No, I didn't even remember that part. I meant all the other things in that letter. You're the same guy.
Yeah.
I mean, we always think we're evolving, but maybe we can't change that much.
You know how I think I've changed the most?
Huh.
When I was younger, I just wanted time to speed up.
You know? Why?
Well, so I could be on my own, so I could be free from my parents and school and all that shit. You know, I just wanted to close my eyes and wake up and be an adult. And now I kind of feel like that happened, and I just want everything to slow down.
Yeah. It's strange. I've always had this feeling, no matter where I am in my life, that it's either a memory or a dream.
I know, you've always thought that. And me too. I mean, it's like, is this really my life? Like, is it happening right now?
It is.
I know. Every year, I just seem to get a little bit more humbled and more overwhelmed about all the things I'm never going to know or understand.
That's what I keep telling you. You know nothing.
I know, and I'm coming around.
But not knowing is not so bad. I mean, the point is to be looking, searching, to stay hungry, right?
I know, it's true. I just wish it was a little easier.
How do you mean?
Well, just to maintain a certain level of passion, you know? Mm. I mean, it used to come so naturally. I mean, I remember when I was younger, me and all my writer friends, we just felt like we were doing something important, you know? Like, this was our time.
But you were all a bunch of arrogant little pricks, right?
No. Maybe. I don't know. It just grew out of all this energy, you know, and this creativity or whatever ambitions people had. You know, it's like, I think you got to be a little deluded to stay motivated.
Young men have this thing about comparing themselves all the time. They have all these signposts they judge themselves by. You used to do that all the time.
Do what? What do you mean?
It was like Rambo wrote this by 17, and Scott Fitzgerald did this
definitely.
By
Balzac wrote a book
30,
before breakfast every day, so what the hell am I doing, you know?
Yeah, but women don't think that way as much.
You don't think so?
No. We have much less to compare ourselves to, maybe. Most women who achieve anything in life, the first time you hear about them, they're in their 50s because it was so hard for them to get any recognitions before then. They struggled for 30 years, or They raised kids and were stranded at home before they could finally do what they want. Actually, you know what? Hmm. It's kind of freeing. We don't have to spend our lives comparing ourselves to Martin Luther King, Gandhi, Tolstoy.
Well, what about Joan of Arc, right? I mean, she was a teenager and she saved France.
Who wants to be Joan of Arc, okay? No? Forget France. She was burned at the stake and a virgin, okay? Nothing okay. I aspire right. to. Right. What a great right. achievement. Right. Oh, God.
What?
No, nothing.
What?
This is so weird.
What do you mean?
just this, us walking, having a conversation about something else than scheduling, food, right. work.
Yeah, I mean, how long's it been since we just wandered around bullshitting?
Do you hear what I hear?
You see?
No.
What? Oh, no small feet.
Mm-hmm.
No, aww. Nothing being knocked over, nothing we have to clean up, no injustices being done.
Yeah, so when was the last time?
When we had nowhere we had to be.
Yeah.
You remember walking around Luxembourg Gardens?
Yeah.
Yeah. I used to kick your ass at ping pong on those concrete tables.
Hey, congratulations, you beat a woman pregnant with twins.
Well, it's better
such
than
a gentleman.
Losing to a pregnant woman with
yeah.
twins, okay?
Oh, God.
You know what I think? I think it's from the time we leave our parents' house until we have kids. I mean, that's the only time your life is completely your own. Mm-hmm. You know, I think I had about a decade of that. It's great. It was just like one long flowing. A day, a week, a year, there wasn't much difference.
No, I used to keep track of time, you know, through jobs and boyfriends and stuff like that. Now I can tell you every detail of the past 7 years, okay, based on what was happening in the girls' lives.
Yeah, right, totally.
You do that too?
Yeah, yeah, I mean, time's demarcated now.
Really?
What?
No, Why? No, I'm surprised. I'm surprised you do that too. No, but, okay, quick test.
Oh,
you know,
no.
August 2009. Oh. No, August, come on, it's a quick one. What was
August
happening?
August 2000, we were on vacation with your parents. Nina got the chicken pox first, quickly followed by Ella.
I'm so impressed.
Yeah, so do I get a gold star?
Maybe. Mm-hmm. Hey, can I ask you a question?
Sure.
If we were meeting for the first time today on a train, would you find me attractive?
Of course.
No, but really, right now, as I am, would you start talking to me? Would you ask me to get off the train with you?
Well, I mean, you're asking a theoretical question. I mean, what would my life situation be? I mean, technically, wouldn't I be cheating on you?
Okay, why can't you just say
no,
yes?
No, I did. I
no,
said,
no, no.
of course.
I wanted you to say something romantic and you blew it,
okay?
Okay,
all right, wait. If I saw you on a train, okay, listen, I would lock eyes with you.
Uh-huh.
And I'd walk right up to you and I'd say, hey, baby, you are making me as horny as a billy goat in a pepper patch.
Stop it. That's disgusting. Billy goat? No, the truth is, okay, you failed the test. And the fact is, you would not pick me up on a train. You would not even notice me, a fat-ass middle-aged mom losing her hair.
Okay.
Yeah, that's me.
You set me up to fail on
okay,
this one. You
true,
did, all right?
True, true.
All right? But in the real world, Baldy, okay, on game day when it mattered, I did talk to you on a train, okay? I did that. It was the best thing I ever did.
Really?
Right?
Look at the goats.
Hey.
Hello.
Yeah. But, you know, that's not even a good question, all right? The real question would be, if I did ask you to get off a train,
yeah,
would you get off with me?
No, of course not. I have people
yeah,
waiting
see,
for
so?
Me. You know, and a 41-year-old horny billy goat? How creepy! I'm creeped out right now. Help, Bohitia!
I can't believe I'm 41.
Yeah, me neither. You've gotten so old. I never thought I'd sleep with anyone over 40.
No.
Actually, you know what? You're what? The oldest guy I've ever slept with.
Well, that's something.
That's true. Yeah,
I know I'm not the oldest guy you've ever blown.
What?
That conference in Warsaw.
What conference?
Lech Walesa.
Lech Walesa.
It's
oh,
okay.
What are you talking
it
about?
It was before we were together. It's, oh. You can admit it. I can remember the way you talked about how he opened your heart. You
oh,
definitely blew him.
Okay.
Definitely.
You're really crazy. That was Gorbachev, okay? You
okay.
geographically
right. well,
challenged football-obsessed, donut-loving American. That was Gorbachev.
I'm sorry, I got
and
my
I,
Eastern Bloc leaders mixed up,
and
okay?
I didn't blow him
okay.
at all, okay? All right. Take it back.
Okay.
God.
So was it Vaclav Havel?
All right, you know.
Thank you.
Still there? Still there? Still there?
Credit card.
Oh, I think the room is paid for.
Yeah.
Yes, it is, but the credit card is for Japan at the home, for all possible outcomes.
Incidentals.
Right, of course.
Mr. Wallace.
Yeah.
I'm such a fan of these two books. My husband gave me your book on our first date, and then when your second book came out, we read it out loud together.
Oh,
would you please sign them to
Of course, of course. I love the artwork in these Greek editions. Mm. It's really nice. What do you need?
Make it to Sophia and Pavlos.
Okay. Has the Greek translation?
Well, it's called Αυτή τη φορά και εκείνη τη φορά. But I'm not sure it's the correct one.
Right, well, that's because you never read it in English, right?
Exactly. That's great. Could you sign them too?
Me?
Yes. You're the real Madeline, right?
Madeline? Not really. I mean, people assume it's me, but it's not me at all. I mean, he's got a big imagination.
Would you be so kind? It would mean so much to my husband.
I can't sign a book I didn't write. It doesn't make...